Hi everyone, here's Maya again. Today's tutorial is gonna be a halter top Muwana Princess. We're going to make in mustard color. I already have started because I don't want the video to be so long. So first you have to make a cup. So now I'm gonna put the link. You just look on the right corner, I guess, it's gonna have the little eye, and there you click, then you will go back to the old video, the video before this one, which I show how to make a bra cup. So you make the cup first until you arrive here in the end of the cup, and then you make the double crochet. From that video you will see how to do it, and when you're done with that, then you come back here. So I wanted to show you this one. I make small size and it's more like XS to S also can wear this one. So if you are 32B, you can wear this one. What I made of the stitch, I start with 11 stitch and then I do three more chain to build up the yarn, and then I crochet along here. So when you go back to that video, you know what I mean. And if you are bigger cup, then you add more stitch. So at the beginning, I start with 11 for this one. If you are one cup more or two cup bigger, then you add three more chains, so become 13. And then you, if you're bigger, then you make 15. And if you're bigger, you make 17, 18. Just see how it works for you. And what you can do is also you can put the cup, when you just start in the first two row, you can already put it against your body. And this one must be, you know, your breast, and here's the middle of your breast, so this should reach the middle of your breast. I hope you understand what I mean. So let's continue. When you got into this part, the bottom under the breast, you will do double crochet along the way and then you come back to me here. So from here, what we're going to do, we're going to chain 5 turn our work, and then we skip 2 chain, we double crochet in the third chain, in the third we skip these 2 stitch and we double crochet in the third one, and then again we chain 2. And then we skip 2, double crochet in the next one. And this is what you're going to do along. As you can hear the voice outside my window, opposite the street is a kindergarten, what you call in English, in German it's a kindergarten. And then the last one here, you skip 2, I don't know if you see, it's 2, 1, 2, and then you pick the last stitch, don't miss it. You see, this is how it look like. Looks like. Sometimes my English is just hard to understand. So this is the cup. So you're going to make 2 cups the same. First one you're gonna cut the thread, and the second one you're not gonna cut the thread. You're just gonna continue. So what we're going to do, we're going to I'll show you the top that I already made. I mean my top. Now we're going to make this part under here. We're gonna connect the two together. Gonna make this part. So from this one, we're gonna turn and then you can see. So from here you're gonna chain 5 again. So I already chained 1, so 2, 3, chain 5, and then you double crochet here, 2, create the same loop. I'm gonna make the camera a little bit brighter. You can see. Okay, now it's better. Yeah. And from now on, now we just do this to make a little like this one, the design. A little bit hold here. So in here, we do 2 double crochet inside. See, 2 double crochet inside. The color is not that yellow though, it's more like mustard, I think, because of the light. Yeah, but it's okay. Just want to make sure that you can see it clear, even though it's too bright the color. So now you're gonna double crochet along here and count also so that you will make the same. So now 2 and then you count 1, 2 and then you count 3, 4, 5. So you're gonna double crochet along here until here, just one before. This is the middle one. You would stop here, okay? And then I meet you there. Okay, here I am. I done this row. So I count. I don't count this one because this is the border. So I just count from here to here. So for me, small size, I mean, it's depend also from how many stitches you make from the cup. So for me, from here to here is 23 stitches. So it doesn't matter if you're bigger, you make bigger cup, then you just have to make sure that you do the same with the other side. That is why I asked you to count. So from here you will chain 5. And now you're gonna connect these 2 cup together. So as we stop before on this stitch, the other side, just 1, 2 before the middle one. This the middle one. This one we don't crochet. So we're gonna go in this one. Oh, it sounds so complicated. So let's say this is the middle one, and then you skip 1, and then you go the next one from here. So then you just, this how you do. You do a double crochet. This is how I do, but you can find your way to do the way you feel comfortable. So I put the yarn around needle, then you go here, then wrap. Okay, this is how I connect it together. And now you're gonna crochet, double crochet along here until here, and then you will put 2 inside here. So here I finish it. I come to the end. What I wanted to tell you also before, when I was explaining to you, I somehow accidentally go into this thread, and in the end I count 1 stitch is missing. So I have to take everything out and start again. And this is why it's so important that you count your stitch every time you crochet, because you want to have them both the same, not one less and one more. So, and here, okay, I wanted to show you and I hope it cannot be seen. Here I connect another yarn inside because I finished the first row and the first ball of yarn. So if you want to know how I connect with no thread seen, how I connect the yarn together, then I will put the link here around here in the corner with the I as well, to go to the video for the beginner class that I show how to connect the yarn. So here at the end until here I got 23 stitch, and then the last one as the border I didn't count. So when you come to the last one here, you need to have this one as well, so that is kind of like the end of the row. And then when you got here and you chain two, I have a little difficulty to say chain. So then you look the third stitch from here or from here, anyways in the middle, then you will double crochet in there to create also the border here. And now we have two connected. So what we are going to do next is to double crochet back along here. So you will chain in the corner, always chain five. If there's little box, this design, I don't know, I will call it a box design. When you have the box there, you always chain five to start. Now two. Five. And then you turn your work. And then again, here, you see the first stitch. You go there, double crochet, and now you would double crochet all along until here, five. You also double crochet inside each five here, and don't forget to count here, 32 I have, and then five, and then here, doesn't matter how many you have, just make sure they are the same, and then I will meet you here. Okay, now I arrive here. This height looks so far. Like this. So the next row is a little bit different. We start the same with five. We turn our work and then we crochet on this, the top of this half double crochet. Top of the double crochet in the previous row. See? And what we are going to do here, let me think. So just let's try this together. I think this is how it works. So I'm going to put one more of the double crochet. Now two. To look the old one, sometimes I just don't remember anymore how I do it. So let's try two and then one chain, and then the same chain space that you have two double crochet inside, you put another two. I want to create a little shell stitch like this, and then the next one we're going to put a single crochet. Let's see. Let's do four single crochet in each stitch. So one, and then the next one. Two. Three. Four. Like this. And then the next stitch, we're going to put two double crochet. One chain the same stitch, 2 double crochet inside. Can you see? So create a little shell stitch like this, and then you put 4 single crochet. 2, 3, 4. Look good. This is how it look. So you're going to repeat this. Next one, 2 double crochet, 1 chain, 2 double crochet, and then single crochet 4, and then the next one. So keep repeat this until the end. I don't know how many it would be because I just never count. We'll see. I meet you there. Okay, here how it looks. How it looks so far. As you can see here in the end, I actually have 4 stitch already of single crochet, and I normally would do 2 double crochet in there, but if I do 2 double crochet in there, then here it will end with single crochet instead of, you know, we start like this in the end. So what am I going to do when this happens? I always just add more of single crochet. I just have 3 more stitches left, so I just add 2 more of single crochet, and the last one I do this double crochet, chain 1, let's see how it turned out. So it's like this, and then I chain 2, then I will find the third stitch somewhere here, and I will do a double crochet. So this is how I did, but you can do different. You just find the solution, because I wanted this both side to be the same. That's why I create this. But it's entirely up to you how you're going to create your top. If you don't like my way, then you just find your way. So the bottom is finished like this. As you see here, we have 1, 2, 3 row. 2, 3 row. Yeah, finished like this. And now we're going to make this part. This pretty high neck, really elegant. So we're gonna do start from here. So go ahead and chain 1 before you cut the yarn. So to start the neck part, you will have to come to the corner here, and then look for the third stitch. So I'm going to put the crochet in hook here. And I'm going to insert the yarn. I leave a little bit tail like this, like so. So you're gonna attach the yarn. I do just pull the yarn in, chain 5. I just leave the tail here. I will sew it in later when I finish. And then here in the corner, just like we need to create this border, so we double crochet in there. Let me look how this one. Okay, so in this space we're going to put 2 double crochet inside. Sometimes I just need to look my work before because I don't have any pattern written down. I just remember, I'll just look at it again. Okay, so two inside. And then again, just like on the bottom part, you will just have to double crochet. Here's the first one, don't miss it. Here's, where is this holding there? So here's the first stitch. So you're going to do here along the way. And the same, this is the middle stitch. You will skip, I mean, you will not get to that anyway. You will just crochet until this is your, will be your last stitch. And for me, it's gonna be again the same stitch as before, 23 until here. So I'm gonna meet you there. So here, I arrive here. And now you will see like three stitch that we leave it free. 1, 2, 3, we not crochet inside. So from here, we will chain 5 again, just like the under breast part. And then we will connect as well. From here, we will find also skip 1, 2, 3. So we're going to the third. From here, we can check because we want it to be the same. So we're just gonna skip this 3 and then we're gonna double crochet in here. You know what I mean? So here is the last one from this side, from the under part. 1, 2, 3, and then we go here. So we do like before. Just a little bit complicated for me. The camera, but I do it. Then you will crochet again here, up, back here, until the last chain here, and then you put two inside here, just in this chain space, and then you admit you there. So I arrive here to the two chain in the chain space. So I will need to put one more in here. I call the border double crochet. So I put one here and then I chain 2, and then here, right here in the corner, double crochet in there. This how it look like. See, now we have connected 2 parts together so far. For those who don't like to have the little space here, instead of 5, you could put 3 chain and then double crochet here and then 3 chain and up here. Just an idea, but I do this way because this I got an order and this how the customer would like to have. So let's move on to the next one, the exciting part. So in the corner as usual, it's not. You're going to chain 5, turn our work, and then we will double crochet inside here, bottom part, and then we'll chain 2, skip 2, skip this 2, and then go to the third one. Then you do again chain 2. And skip 2 and then go to the third one. And this what you're going to do along the way until you arrive the last chain around here, and then I meet you there. I show you how to decrease the stitch so that it will fit the body. So here I am. I arrive 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have 8 boxes. I have to count, and I encourage you to do the same, because like I said, you need to have both sides same. So I have 8, and here, look, we have just 1, 2 left, and then we have 5 chain here. What am I going to do? This 5, 6, 7, we're gonna calculate a little bit. So we wanted to have the same, like to balance both sides. So these 2, I block it here, and these 2. All the stitches together, now we have 5 in the middle, 2 in the right, and 2 in the left, so it's 9. Then I'm going to chain 3, because I wanted to make 7. And I'm gonna find the middle, the third stitch, like 5, and then 1, 2, 3, the third stitch, yeah, of the 5, of the 5 chain. So 2, and then I, inside in the middle, I make double crochet 1, and then chain 1. So it's like 2, 3, 4. Then I put 5. Now I have 5. And then I chain 2, 6, 7. Do you know what I mean? It's so hard to explain. So yeah, 9, and I want to make only 7 stitch in the middle. So I chain 2. Then this count as 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And now I'm going to do a double crochet on the third stitch from this side. So 1, 2 here. This is how it looks like. Please, if you have any question, you just ask. I hope you understand what I mean. So now we're going to chain 2, and then skip 2, and then go to the third. And you're going to do the same across here, and then meet you there. So I got here. I also count again. I have 8 boxes the same. Yeah. So we're going to repeat the same thing again, as we're going to have a 2 row of this box design. So you do the same again until you got here. And now what you're going to do in the middle, I'm just gonna explain, it's faster. So you do the same thing, chain 2, and then on the top, this is gonna be the last double crochet here. So in the previous row, we have 2 chain here. So when you come here, you just do 1 chain, and then you will put 2 double crochet. Okay, you do 1 chain, and then inside of this chain space, you're going to put 1 double crochet, chain 1, and 1 double crochet. And then you will just chain 1. You're going to decrease. So here, you're going to chain 1, and then double crochet here, chain 2, double crochet here, everything the same here until we get here. And then I'll meet you here and see if you understand what I mean. So here you see the first row, we do a double crochet along the row here. So this is what happened. The next one, we're going to do also double crochet. You chain 5, double crochet here, and then 2 double crochet inside, double crochet here on the top, 2 inside, and 1 here on the top, 2 inside, 1 here on the top, 2 inside, 1 here on the top. Come until you arrive here. This is the last double crochet you will make here, and you will not do 1 chain anymore. You're just gonna skip, and you're going to do 1 double crochet inside chain space, and 1 chain, 1 double crochet, and then you will skip this one as well. You're going to put double crochet here, 2 double crochet inside, 1 double crochet, 2 inside, 1 here, 2 inside, 1 here, along until you got here, this is the last double crochet, two chain, and then you do, I will meet you here and then I show you. So here I have complete this row, and this is what I want to show you. Doesn't matter if you make double crochet here or this design, in the side, both side, you need to have this hole, this box. So what I do, as I explained to you before, one double crochet, two inside, one double crochet on top of double crochet in previous row, two inside, and you do along the way. When you arrive to the middle part, you don't chain one anymore because we want to decrease. We want it to make it smaller in the front, like to make it to fit our breast, our chest. So you just gonna, from here, then you just gonna put one double crochet inside this space, and then chain one double crochet, and then you jump to here. There's no more chain also here. It have to be the same. So now we are going to do again, repeat this design. We're going, either you can stop here and you just have in this way, and also beautiful this way. If you want, you just have to chain long about 100 for tie around your neck, and then you have to add the side, or you can just leave like this. I will add this side as well. So we're going to do this two again, and we're gonna, every row we're gonna decrease two stitches from both sides, one here and one here. So we're going to do this. Let's start it. So to start the next one, you're going to chain five and then single crochet here, chain two, skip two, single crochet here. It have to be matched in this line, and I will meet you in the middle before we go to the other side. I'm gonna meet you around here. Okay, here I am. I arrive here, and instead of I chain two, instead of I put one double crochet here, I decide to skip this double crochet here, because now if I count the chain, I count the stitch, I have 1, 2, 3 here, 4, 5, 6, and then I have to plus 3 here, 7, 8, 9. So this one is the, you see we have 9 stitch in the middle. So I'm going to do, like in the beginning, I'm going to chain 2, and then I'm going to put double crochet inside. I already chained 2 in the, from my crochet hook. So I'm going to put double crochet inside. Cut as 3. We're trying to just have everything 7 because we want to decrease 2 stitch. 1, 2, then 3, 4. Then one more inside. 5. Then chain 2, 6, 7. See, from 9 we make it 7, and then we going to double crochet on the, yeah, to be the same as this one, which means it's this one we're going to double crochet inside here. I hope you know what I mean. This is how I decrease the stitch, and you're going to do the same the other side, chain 2, double crochet, chain 2, double crochet, until you get there. So I did one row done, and then I come back here to here in the middle again, and as the previous row we chain 2, now we're going to just chain 1, and then we do the same. Sometimes the stitch is loose, so you just have to hold it tight, and then you just hold it tight, make sure that it's tight enough and not loose, so this is better. Chain 1, see, and then you're just gonna double crochet in here, chain 2, double crochet along the way until here. And then when you arrive here, you will repeat this again, this double crochet and then I will meet you in the middle to show you how to decrease. So here how it looks so far. I finished this row and I want to show you how I decrease in the middle. So the previous row we have one chain here, so this one there's no chain between this one to the middle part. So when you come here with double crochet, then you will just one double crochet inside, one chain, one double crochet, and then you see there's nothing between, then you just put double crochet here too, like before. Now we're going to do again these two row, so we do the same, and when you arrive here I will meet you here and then I show you how to decrease. So here I am, arrived to the middle part. From here I have made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 box, and here I have 3 stitch. Normally I would just put one double crochet here, but now I will not do that. So 3, I will just chain 2 and then I will do this middle design inside. So I will do 2 because he has 3, right? I just skip like 1, so that is get a little smaller, and I go inside and I will do the same design like the previous rows, and then chain 2 again, and then I'm not gonna do this one, I'm gonna go here instead, right? Yeah, it's 3, so I'm going to skip, I'm going here. And this what I'm going to do along until the end, and now I'm just going to explain to you until the end. Then you come back here, you will arrive here, and now in this row you chain 2, the next one you just chain 1, and then you go inside, same, chain 1 and then go back. I will meet you here. Yay, almost there. So I have complete the second row also, as I mentioned before. Oops, this one, just one chain, because this 2 and then this one, just one. So one more row, then we're gonna finish. We're gonna do one double crochet all along, one more row, and then we're done. So what you're going to do, same as before, when you arrive here in the middle, you'll be, this gonna be the last one. Then when you arrive here, there's no more chain here, we skip. So from here, then we go directly inside, no chain. Here the last double crochet, and then one double crochet, one chain, one double crochet, and then one double crochet here, 2 inside, 1 here, 2 inside, 1 here, 2 inside, along until here, and then you're done. So here we show you, so the last row of double crochet, like I have mentioned to you before, the middle part here, there's no chain because he has 1, so he has no to decrease. So when I arrive here, I just directly chain up here. This is the strap that will go around the neck, like so. I chain 90 this time, both sides. And for the body part, I'm not gonna show you everything again because I already have the first video of the crescent moon top. We did the same. So from that, I show you step by step how to add this one to the side. And after that, you will need to make this strap as well. Extra one for, see like this, for tie in the back. I made 300 chain. And voila, you got the top for summer. And you just have to sew the thread in with your needle. I will put the photo after when I finish everything. I will take some photo and also add it in the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you enjoy the tutorial. If you have any question, please put them down below so that author can benefit from your question. And if you are an advanced level, you have an advice for my video or for other people who have questions, feel free to answer the question as well, because everyone are free to give the opinion and help each other to be better in crochet. And this way we learn from each other.